Hello guys, welcome to my fourth class of probability distribution class. Now let us discuss today class is binomial distribution. Now the question is arise, actually you already discussed in previous classes discrete random variable distribution. Under the discrete random variable distribution, they have two distribution in engineering level. There are binomial distribution and Poisson distribution. Now we have to consider one of the distribution is called binomial. Now just 1 second before that, I told binomial distribution is one of the distribution comes under discrete random variable distribution. Now, and also I told you have a Poisson distribution also. How can you have to know that in which case I go for binomial? If you want to go for binomial distribution, it must be satisfies the following conditions. The condition number one is trial or experiment must be repeated and finite. The trial is a repeated trials, and also the trial must be countable. Countable means that must be a finite. Next is outcomes of the each of the trial must be independent. Now once you find outcome is, suppose you, I'll give a example later. For each trial, we are expecting only two outcomes. That is, one is success, another one is failure. You can't expecting more than two outcomes in any trial. Probability of success and failure of one trial, suppose you find out, it must be remain in the rest of the trials. Means if you want to go for binomial distribution, what are the condition must be satisfied? Trial must be repeated and also finite. Second point is outcome of each of the trials must be independent. And then each trial we are expecting only two outcomes. One is a success, another one is a failure. The next one is probabilities of, suppose you find out probabilities of success and failure of any one of the trial, it must be remain rest of the trials. For example, now then only we go for binomial distribution. Suppose you violate any one of these conditions, you can't go for binomial distribution. Such a trial, what such type of trial, what we are considered repeated finite trials, such trials are called Bernoulli trials. The corresponding distribution is called Bernoulli binomial distribution. For example, I consider one example, tossing a coin thrice. Once you tossing a coin thrice, we repeated same trial how many times? 3 times. They have repeated, they must be finite, means countable, 3. Thus, trial I treated as Bernoulli trial. Why? Because observe carefully here, repeated trial, this is repeated with finite number, because tossing a coin is 3 times, is a repeated coin, we repeated same thing, but countable number of times, means finite number. Next is, you know that tossing a coin, we are expecting only two outcomes. What are the two outcomes you are expecting? One is a success, another one is failure. Suppose you are going to take, getting a, what about head is a success, and then getting a tail is a failure. You can't expecting more than two outcomes. That is satisfy the second condition. Suppose you take for toss a coin once. What's the probability of head? Getting a head is 1 by 2. What's the probability of getting a tail is 1 by 2. Therefore, the probability of getting a head and tail are 1 by 2 for one trial. Suppose you toss a second time, you find out what is the probability of that trial. Whatever probability of success and failure means getting a head and tail are again 1 by 2, 1 by 2. Suppose you toss a coin third time, what's the probability of getting head and tail are nothing but what actually 1 by 2, 1 by 2. Therefore, that must be remain constant. Then outcomes of the each trials are independent. Observe carefully outcomes of the each of the trial. For example, suppose you toss a coin first, we get a head. Suppose you toss a coin second time, we get a tail. Getting a tail for the second toss does not depending upon getting a tail of the first toss. Therefore, how we you toss based on that we get a head or tail for each of the cases. Therefore, you are tossing a coin is a independent trial. Therefore, it's an example of Bernoulli trial, and also process is called Bernoulli distribution, means binomial distribution. Now, if you want to find out a solution in the binomial distribution, what's the probability function? The probability function formula is P of x is equal to ncx into p power of x into q power of n minus x. Ncx is nothing but n factorial by x factorial into n minus x factorial. That can also be denoted by b of x comma p comma n. And if we see here in engineering level is not included formula for derivation for mean and standard deviation. Therefore, consider what's the mean formula is np, what's the variance is npq, what's the square root of npq is nothing but standard deviation. Let us come and meet in the next class for the problems based on the binomial distribution. Thank you very much.